walking around the Christmas tree. That sounds like the thing to do. This is DDP.
If I said that. Face music. Smile.
In the middle of the picture.
Ooh. I'm gonna waste it.
I told you.
Why didn't you tell me this afternoon when I talked to you? Remind me. I didn't even think about it. Give it to me and let me film you.
However,
I want to film
you. I would have turned him and gotten here in 25 minutes on that beltway. You went the toll road. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I've done that too.
Well, the toll road. Different time. Only those two little birds. He wants my chicken toes this morning. Is it looking good? You gonna eat more of that crab apple? I don't think I need more of these crackers. That's a gingerbread man. It's my birthday. What have you got until... You've got to win.
Here we go. The dude is going to sing Happy Birthday to Mimi. Go ahead and do it.
Say it louder.
Happy birthday to you.
Ah, oh, that's pretty.
That's
sing
great. Can you do it again?
Remember the rest of it?
Do you remember the rest of it?
No. Oh, I got it.
You done? You going to give everybody a kiss?
Now, introduce the camera to me, Mommy. Get me, Mommy, on the camera. No, you have to go over and show him where to take it. Do it. Say, this is me, Mommy. These are all the same. There's just two.
Which one's that?
Whichever one you want.
They're alike, aren't they?
Well, these three are different. These are serious.
No, I like this one, Shannon, but I like that one. I like that one upstairs here.
Well, then, Mom, you give Grandma the one that's upstairs, and you take one of these.
No, this is the lady's style.
Tarzi. What do you see? Get them.
Get your good girl.
Who is going to come get you?
Lorraine. Lorraine told me this morning she would.
Okay.
What are you telling me, honey?
Filming your mother-in-law telling me about.
Said she missed me. Oh, she was up. She's going to bed at 3 o'clock this morning. Then wake 5 and got up.
I bet Mother didn't even go to bed for her to be ready that early.
Lorraine told me how well she slept. See, her husband died a year ago this month. And she was sleeping well. But he heard too many his tunes.
Did you get any ice last night?
No.
Tatum's getting on a new outfit. See? Tatum's getting on a new outfit. Look at the camera, Tanner. Look in the camera. Say hi. Say hi, people. Say hi. Say, there's my baby.
I tell you, summer babies are a whole lot easier to dress. You just throw a little t-shirt on them and it's over with. I thought this was supposed to be in the front.
It snaps up the front and no wonder that.
Look. Now you tell me.
Yeah.
I held
it up. Now.
Now look at the feet.
Yeah, you're right.
I almost had her dressed. They're going to be wondering why we're in here for another hour. Saying they're taking that baby home.
It's taking 4 hours to get that baby home.
Tanner, what's your baby's name?
The beauty parlor faster.
What's your baby's name, Tanner? What?
Pam.
Who?
Pam.
Pam.
Tatum.
Tatum.
Is whose baby is that?
Tatum.
Who's taking your picture? Uncle Frank.
Uh-huh.
You like him? Mm-hmm. Is he a nice guy?
He needs to think about it.
Oh, bless you, darling.
He's perspiring.
No, Mommy.
Tanner, are you the big brother? Is it tough being a brother? How long you been a brother?
A day.
Huh? Have you been a brother for a couple days?
Say, it's a hard job being brother.
Are you going to take...
I need my baby.
You need your baby. The baby's going home. Going to Tanner's house.
You going to let the baby play with your toys, Tanner?
Are you going to show her how to do the puzzles and read your Big Bird book?
What are you going to teach the baby?
You going to teach her how to play ball?
Uh-huh.
Will you play baseball with her?
What kind of ball?
Baseball.
So why don't we just wrap her in that blanket and not this?
I don't think it'd be warm enough out there.
Hey, Tatum.
Sit here just a minute. Just a minute. Sit down.
I got you.
I want my baby.
No, you can't have your baby right now.
When we get home, you can see her. Look at her. Is she pretty?
Oh, my.
Get out, Frank. Get out
where you can see her face.
Don't tell me. That.
Get it one of these. Pay them, smile big.
Smile big. You've got to be careful.
You're in your first movie.
All right, look, look. I don't think that's funny.
I guess you'll critique my film work later, huh?
To continue. Timmy, come on down.
Okay, say the date for me again.
I don't remember the dates. Back in the...
No, right, today's date. December?
Oh, December 12, 1992.
Okay, now let's go back.
All right. Back in my younger days, there were no cars. We walked and went to parties. Every young girl and boy in the valley would go together. We would walk and have parties. There was one of my friends called Little Rob Henderson, because I had a cousin, first cousin, who was Rob Henderson, the undertaker, but this Little Rob Henderson was my boyfriend. And he was the first one that ever got a car. He came down one Sunday evening late, wanted to take us to Lindale to church service that night. And my mother said, I asked my mother if we could go. Of course, I knew my sister and brothers had to go too. She says, go see your daddy. He heard us talking. He ran and hid in the garden to keep from saying yes or no. I went out looking for him, found him behind something in the garden. I says, may we go to Lindale to church tonight? He says, who's going? I says, well, there's a bunch of us going. He says, who's going to take you? I says, well, Rob Henderson says, well, if there's going to be a carload, you may come back if you'll promise to come right after church. And we did. We came back. The next event, I had several boyfriends at that later on, but the one that came true was one Christmas, my father was on the porch, and he saw Frank coming up the road in a wagon drawn by horses. And he says, here he comes, bringing your casket. But what he was bringing me was a cedar chest for my Christmas present. And I have that Christmas present yet today. Then my father and I had several discussions about Frank and I. He thought I ought to marry somebody rich, somebody had some money. Frank had no money. Frank went on a trip once to visit a cousin of his in North Carolina somewhere, and he got me a present. It was a dog. And on that, it's some kind of specimen you're made out of, I was made out of. It says, can't you talk? I still have it. And then the next thing, Frank and I were sweethearts for a long, long time. And my father didn't agree on it, but I knew that he loved me and I loved him. And so when we did get married, of course, my father was a friend to him. My mother liked him real well. And my parents were Primitive Baptists, but Frank and I were Methodists. We went to Methodist Church. Primitive Baptists were out. Then I can't remember. Next thing that happened was when my son, Frank the second.
Junior. Frank Junior.
Huh?
Junior.
Yeah. Was born. And we went, everybody was hollering that Frankie was born, Frankie was born. Well, for years, I took him to church, carried him in my arms to church. It wasn't very far away, we had no car. My father was first owner of a truck in that vicinity, and he did that because he had my business. And 2 years later, my second son was born, Bobby. And my sister had dated a man by the name of Lee Thomas. So Frankie's grandfather was Bob Grace, and we named my son Bobby Lee after those two people. Well, we lived there for years. I took them to church every Sunday morning. Carried Bobby, and Frankie was old enough to walk. And when they got old enough to go to school, I taught Frank Jr. for 2 years. And every morning we start school, Bobby'd scream and cry, let me go with you. But he wasn't old enough to go.
Then when Bobby was, he lacked a month of being old enough to go, I took him one day, but they found out his age and they stopped me. So Bobby was almost, he was past six when he got to go in the first grade. But Frankie at that time was already